वहीं पर होगी जहां हाई स्पीड कॉरिडोर होंगे।
As the fifth largest economy in the world with an enormous population of 1.4 billion, India appears as a prominent country on the map. The Indian Railways, or IR, operates 12,600 trains to carry over 23 million passengers daily. For context, this is equivalent to moving the entire population of Australia regularly. With over 7,000 stations spread across the country, India has the largest rail network in Asia and the third largest on the planet with a length of 42,280 miles. That's not to say that it comes without its share of problems. Let's take a look at some of the challenges that the Indian Railway faces today and whether they can overcome them. Will a mega project like a bullet train project help India become a global superpower? Starting with the most obvious issue, overcrowding. There's a mad rush for trains on high-density routes, particularly during weekends, major festivals, and summer holidays. The station's jam-packed hours before the train arrives, and when it does, all hell breaks loose. The trains are filled four times their capacity, with people being forced to either stand or sit in passages or even occupy toilets. Those who buy tickets for unreserved seats most of the time don't even get a seat as there's a swarm of ticketless commuters. As the fares have been kept low, the railways become a lifeline for the working-class communities with carpenters and masons using it frequently to travel for seasonal work. The Indian Railway prides itself on being the cheapest form of transport as it bears 53% of the passenger cost. In 2021-2022, the railways spent INR 602,170 million on subsidized travel. While it may benefit local travelers, the department's incurring financial losses, which further hampers its success. The railway's IT systems are so slow that they can process only 25,000 bookings per minute, making it an impossible task to get a reservation on a busy train. Officials are working to increase the bookings capacity to 225,000 per minute. Then there's the issue of delays. Research done in 2017 found that the average train was late by 53 minutes, making 30% of trains late in this period. Improper infrastructure like the unavailability of platforms with sufficient length, lack of stabling, and washing pit lines are the main reason behind the delays. Due to the less capacity of platforms, the trains have to wait at the outer signal or the adjacent station until it's vacated by preoccupied trains, leading to a 15-minute delay per train. But that's not the worst part about the Indian Railways. It's the loss of thousands of lives due to train-related accidents every year. According to the National Crime Record Bureau's 2022 report, more than 100,000 train-related deaths were reported between 2017 and 2021. These include collisions, people being run over, and passengers falling from trains. A staggering 69% of these incidents are caused by derailments. This shows that fixing tracks and related infrastructure should be the top priority of the authorities. In June 2023, India saw its worst train crash in 20 years, killing 261 and injuring 1,000 people in the Odisha state. A passenger train traveling from Calcutta derailed after hitting a stationary goods train. However, several of its coaches ended up on the opposite track. Unfortunately, the Howrah Superfast Express, which was traveling in the opposite direction, hit the overturned carriages. The force with which the trains collided with one another resulted in several coaches being crushed and mangled. With the development of highways, most citizens are utilizing cars or buses instead of the chaotic railways. The most obvious downside of both of these is that they take more hours than the train to reach their destination. Surely, millions of Indians require a safe, efficient, and more comfortable mode of transport for their daily lives. The development of a high-speed rail network is also crucial if India truly wants to become a global superpower. In fact, its regional partners like South Korea, China, Japan, Indonesia, and Russia have developed their bullet train systems, so why should India lag behind? To solve this, the government's starting to take steps in the right direction. And while a widespread high-speed rail network isn't currently available, there are subsections of the country that have it. For example, the Vande Bharat Express is a semi-high-speed electric rail operating in major cities like Mumbai, Chennai, and New Delhi, among others. Its top speed was set at 100 miles an hour, but due to traffic congestion and the speed limit of the tracks, it operates at 99 miles an hour. India made global headlines when it inaugurated Vande Bharat in 2019, as it set the country's first indigenously designed and manufactured semi-high-speed rail set. Nevertheless, it's safe to say that it's a lot better than the conventional railways. With state-of-the-art facilities like automatic doors, onboard Wi-Fi, GP passenger information system, and 30% less energy consumption, it's a first for Indian Railways and the whole country. But it seems like India's not stopping anytime soon. The Railway Ministry set another ambitious project to make the country's first bullet train. This project is a partnership between the Indian and Japanese governments, with the latter providing funding and technical assistance. Built on the Japanese Shinkansen-style model, the project costs a whopping $14 billion, 81% of which will be provided by Japan as a 50-year loan on an interest rate of 0.1%. The bullet train consists of 24 train sets that'll cover the 332-mile route between Mumbai and Ahmedabad. This high-speed train will cover the distance in just 2 hours compared to the Ahmedabad-Duronto Express, which takes 6 hours and 15 minutes and is currently the fastest way to reach Mumbai from Ahmedabad. Mumbai is the financial hub of India with a huge population of 22 million, the largest in any city. On the other hand, Ahmedabad is the biggest city in the state of Gujarat. Because of its rich culture and history, Ahmedabad has many tourist landmarks and is also an emerging center for education and technology. Connecting these two megacities is not only beneficial for the economy, but also for boosting tourism. The bullet trains will run at a top speed of 200 miles an hour with 12 stations in between the routes, 8 of them being in Gujarat. Just like any other mega project in the world, this one too was conceived many years ago. In 2009, 5 high-speed rail corridors were proposed for a feasibility study. A 400-mile-long high-speed rail corridor was proposed to run from Pune to Ahmedabad via Mumbai. A memorandum was signed in New Delhi between the Indian Ministry of Railway and the French National Railways. Both parties agreed to carry out jointly an operations and development feasibility project on this inner-city route. In March 2013, it was decided to drop the Pune system of the network and only focus on Mumbai and Ahmedabad. This decision was taken due to money troubles, as the mountain range between Mumbai and Pune would increase the budget of the project. Since very little portion of Maharashtra was being covered, the state government was reluctant to bear the financial burden for this subsection. However, some progress started in May when Japan entered the picture. Both the Japanese and Indian prime ministers agreed to co-finance a feasibility report for a railway system with a speed of 190 to 220 miles an hour. The report investigated traffic forecasting, environmental challenges, and the overall engineering requirements for this particular terrain. The survey team recommended bullet train models with automatic control systems and dedicated tracks. Many of these tracks will run parallel to the existing railway tracks in the area. Initially, the construction was expected to be completed by 2023, but due to delays in acquiring land in Maharashtra, the deadline was pushed by 5 years to 2028. Let's talk about the engineering that went into this multi-billion project. The corridor will originate at the 3-story underground station in Bandra Kurla Complex, BKC in Mumbai, and will only see the light of day when it arrives at Thane. The terminal at BKC would also connect Line 3 of the Mumbai Metro. Mumbai Metro is an underground metro service under construction and will be a first for India once completed. This would help travelers from South Mumbai to reach the terminal. Each train will have between 10 and 16 coaches. The passenger capacity of each train would be between 1,300 and 1,600. Coaches will be equipped with multi-purpose rooms that contain foldable beds for feeding mothers and patients, and the rooms will also be fitted with mirrors and baggage racks. In addition, extra space would be provided for heavy luggage at the end of each coach. This modification isn't found in the original Japanese design. 90% of the tracks will be spread on viaducts, 5% in tunnels, and almost 2% on bridges. Even though the elevated infrastructure costs an additional $1.3 billion, it saves the railway's legal troubles revolving around land acquisition and the need to build underpasses. The environmental impact is also significantly reduced, which is great for areas with thick vegetation and wildlife like Thane. The National Board for Wildlife gave conditional approval to cut down 32,044 mangroves, provided that safe passages and noise barriers for animals will be erected before the construction. All of this seems simple in theory, but that's not the case in reality. The biggest challenge is posed by Thane Creek, a large inlet of water standing in the way of construction. Instead of building high above the surface, it was proposed to build an undersea tunnel, the first of its kind in India. This was done to avoid damage to the thick vegetation present in the area. The 13-mile tunnel, 4 miles of which will be below sea, will connect Thane and Virar. As the route traverses many villages, there were protests by local farmers who were against giving up land for this modern amenity. In 2020, Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray even called the project a white elephant and questioned whether anyone would benefit from it. Many citizens were skeptical about this costly venture as they believed that this money could be used to redevelop the existing railway system. However, all these disputes seemed to be settled by 2023, as 100% of the land was already acquired in Maharashtra, while 98% in Gujarat. Currently, the project standing at 30% completion. The Gujarat section of the corridor is completed by 35%, while the Maharashtran side is lagging behind at 19%. For better or for worse, this project will completely transform the social scene, turning the seventh largest country into a small village. The most apt example of this is Japan, which completely revolutionized itself with the inauguration of the bullet train in the 60s. Recovering from the traumatic World War II, these trains were a symbol of Japanese resilience with benefits like job creation, enhanced mobility, and increased efficiency. India could replicate the same model and, with Japan on its back, can become a global superpower in the future. This project is in line with the Made in India initiative, which focuses on bringing international investments and upscaling the manufacturing sector. With global analysts like Goldman Sachs suggesting that India might become the world's second largest economy by 2075, it's only a matter of time before it happens. But for the time, being India's ground reality is quite different. More urgent issues like poverty, illiteracy, unemployment, pollution, healthcare, etc. continue to plague the country. That's why the strongest critics of this project believe in prioritizing other issues instead of accumulating billions of dollars in loans into futuristic bills like these. Do you think that the bullet train is the right investment for the Indian people? Will solving transportation issues help India become the next superpower? Comment your thoughts below. If you liked today's video, don't forget to like and subscribe to Visionary Builds. To see more videos in the future, hit the bell icon to never miss an update.